Welcome to my AI lab, where I apply different AI technologies to the real world. I'm a fan of rock music, but I'm not entirely up on its latest scene. Besides Nickelback always being the butt of a joke, is there a prevalence of superficiality in mainstream rock that true fans cringe over in the same way that exists for hip-hop? If you watched last week's episode, you saw how I analyzed topic trends from the Billboard R&B Hip Hop Year-End Charts. Unsurprisingly, the theme was quite consistent from 2002 through 2017.
My bitch is bad and bougie.
You deserve it, baby, you deserve it all.
It got me thinking. Does the consistency of themes over the years also true of the rock genre? I ran the same NLP topic modeling algorithm to find out. I used the top 5 songs from the Billboard Hot Rock Songs from 2009 through 2017. If you didn't watch last week's episode, topic modeling is just a form of artificial intelligence that helps us to analyze and process speech and text in order to extract meaning from them. The top 5 rock songs from 2009. Yielded I'm, Sleep, and No. The top 5 rock songs from 2017. Yielded I'm, No, and Things. If we stack the topic modeling outputs for all 9 years together, we can see a prevalence of the word I'm and No, but nothing else that points to a central theme throughout the years. So, besides both genres sharing a sense of narcissism, rock doesn't have the same dominant theme characteristic that the R&B hip-hop charts had. Now, it can be difficult to compare genres in this way. There are a lot of cultural and historical influences that AI can't capture. Still, the enjoyment that I get from listening to the top rock songs are every bit as palpable as when I'm listening to Nickelback. They're not that bad. As a casual fan, they're not that bad. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. And I hope you learned a little bit more about what you can do with NLP topic modeling. Thanks for watching. See you next time.